Hi, my name is Mbeng Puka. I'm an artist. This morning I'm going to be presenting the womb of a man, the woman. The idea behind this painting is to portray the value of a woman, to present the reivindication of God in his original intention of creating humanity on earth. Here, when we see woman, it's important to understand the root of philosophy, why men are sometimes think they are the one who have to lord over to the earth. To create a woman has been for God like creating himself. The meaning of creator, creation. What is a creator or an intelligent design or whatsoever name we want to give? To create, nothing in creation have been duplicated. In billions of humans who are on earth, none is the same. We are individually created. And to undertake that kind of walk in the universe, God needed a womb. Without of a womb, there is no one that could have been on earth that is. The womb has been the center of God's imagination into his creativity plan and essence of multiplication. That is the common writing, woman came from men, as described in many books, is not good for men to be alone, never reflect God's knowledge, but the ignorance of men. By looking at the woman body and the conception, that is the essence of God. Every tree and every leaves from a tree is individual. Every fingerprint, that is creation. What human does is not creation. What we do is duplication. We cannot bring out of nothing. We always use something to prove ourselves and to prove ourselves and to prove our ability. That is totally different from God. And the beginning for God is called the end, which is confirmed the mistake humans have been doing by confirming their own writing like being God writing. Because God doesn't undertake work like an architect. God starts always by the end to the beginning. His knowledge starts where our knowledge finish. So it's important for us to put back things as they have been or as they are. The woman, she's the centerpiece of creation, the centerpiece of humanity. Why do the woman is the masterpiece of God? Look at the body, how the woman body is formed. Look at the spheric form, most of her body, how it's shaped. This is the beautiful masterpiece of God. Now, people think that God created man and he found out, oh no, that's a mistake. Then he made that man to be enslaved, to take part of his body, to make a woman. That it doesn't make any sense. Then he wake up the man and the other part was there. Oh no, it doesn't make any sense. This is the reality. When you look at the children, if the woman was coming from the man was supposed to give birth. In so many other spheres of creation, it's the male that multiplies his generation. Now, to have what I call to create, creation walk through multiplication. To create, you need to have the essence of multiplication. The essence of multiplication is the woman. It's the woman that is made to multiplicate children. So God couldn't start with the man. No, it starts with his origin, with his quality, with himself. He's a creator. So to create is to multiply. So God starts by designing the best instrument for multiplication. Why? Because the woman is the son of multiplication. So with a woman, the world could be filled. With a man, the world could have never be filled, because I was born through a woman. So do all the men in this earth. And to confirm my painting, just look at the birth of Jesus. Who is Jesus' father? It's the spirit that went through Mary to infant Jesus. So that is one of the examples that God did not need men to fulfill his word or to multiply his children. He needed just a woman. Thank you very much. Let's wait to the next painting, which is coming, The Power of the Mushroom. Thank you. See you to the next painting.